A very good evening to all of you. Hello and welcome, guys. My name is Kishan Pratap Singh and I welcome one and all to the 19th episode of Weekly Law Scoop. So let me just quickly go through the chat box. Welcome Chirag, welcome Modi ji, welcome Vanshika, welcome Nishtha, welcome Arya, welcome everyone. Well, guys, quickly tell me if the audio is fine and all of you can see the screen. Welcome Palak. Can you please confirm if the screen is fine and all of you can hear me out properly? Welcome Avi, welcome Suruchi. Hello Nishtha. Chali, let's start. Okay, this episode can be called Supreme Court Special because the biggest news of the week is elevation of 9 judges to the Supreme Court. So we are going to discuss that at length, and as usual, we'll move to the menti.com for our regular quiz. For those of you who are attending for the first time, my name is Kishan Pratap Singh. I'm a PhD scholar. I did my law from Law School Punjab and Masters from Law School Kolkata. I'm chief mentor with IMS Learning Resources. And in this session, we cover important legal news item from past 1 week. And the session is culminated with a quiz, a live quiz, which we conduct on Menti. In order to select the best quality, select on the settings tab and pick the best option available. Welcome Ira, welcome Chirag, welcome Vaibhav, welcome Gargi, Chalias, Rutuja, Avi. In order to experience superior CLAT preparation, if you're not from IMS, you can go to imsindia.com and register for free program, and you can go through the course material, videos and test and other content and analyze by yourself. Okay, the biggest news of the week, 9 new judges have been appointed to the Supreme Court. Our President Ramnath Kovind, after accepting the recommendations made by the Supreme Court Collegium, well, Collegium comprises of 5 judges, including the Chief Justice of India, so Justice Ramana, Justice U.U. Lalit, Justice Khanwilkar, Justice Diva Chandrachud and Nageshwar Rao. So Collegium recommended 9 names and President was swift enough to accept all the 9 names. The good thing is that this list of 9 judges includes 3 women and 1 lawyer, so one guy from the bar. Well, so why was it much needed step? Because for last almost 2 years, nobody was elevated to the Supreme Court. So Supreme Court was not adding more judges. For those of you who don't know, the total sanction strength of Supreme Court is 34 judges. So we always say 33 plus 1. So plus 1 here denotes to the Chief Justice of India. Though capacity is of 34, but still Supreme Court was functioning with only 24 judges. Can someone give me the answer why? Why was it that if you have capacity of 34, aap 24 judges se kaam chala rahe hain? Kya lagta aapko? Supreme Court mein social distancing follow ki ja rahi thi? Well, that's not true. The last recommendations were made in August 2019 when Ranjan Gogoi used to be our Chief Justice. Ranjan Gogoi ke baad Justice Bobde bhi ja chuke hain and now we have Justice Ramana. So, what had happened at that time we had Justice Rowington Nariman. Rowington Nariman didn't allow any name to be recommended. And why did he do so? Justice Nariman comes from a very well-known legal family. His father, Fallius Nariman, was the most sought-after lawyer in India. So he dominated the bar for almost 40 years. Well, he was also considered champion of human rights and fundamental rights. Do you know, Fallius Nariman was made our AG during Indira Gandhi's regime. And Fallius Nariman resigned from the government post when Indira Gandhi imposed emergency. So he had the backbone to stand up and say that I don't agree to it. Well, so having those genes, Nariman was also taking a moral stand here. And what was that moral stand? We'll move on to that. Malvika says Akhil Qureshi. Akhil Qureshi is partially correct answer. Okay, no one is qualified. Arya says no one is qualified enough. That's not true. Well, there's a big controversy. The controversy was that whenever we are recommending names, whenever the Collegium recommends name of people to be elevated to the Supreme Court, they consider seniority as one of the major factor. And we have Justice Akil Qureshi, who is currently Chief Justice of High Court of Tripura. So Tripura High Court ke jo Chief Justice hain, wo India ke second senior most judge hain. When you look at the seniority list of all the judges put together, all India judges seniority list, this guy was the second senior most judge in India. So when Justice Akil Qureshi was Chief Justice of Gujarat High Court, at that time he delivered a verdict against Amit Shah. So it was because of Justice Akil Qureshi, Amit Shah was sent to PC. PC here stands for police custody. So Amit Shah ko Amit Shah ko police custody mein bhejne wale judge, kya aapko lagta hai unko Supreme Court mein jane ke liye jagah deni chahiye? Okay, so Satesh says bichare Justice Qureshi. Okay, Arya says no one is qualified. Well, bichare Justice Qureshi, well, when you are walking on the path of justice, you have to bear some consequences. We'll discuss another controversy today where people chose to stand on the right side rather than giving in and getting a plum post. So Amit Shah was one of the accused in Sharabuddin encounter case, and Amit Shah was sent to police custody under Justice Akil Qureshi, and therefore later on when Justice Qureshi's name was recommended by the collegium in which Rowington Nariman was part of it, government rejected that name. So government ne apna consent is naam pe nahi diya. There was one more judge, Chief Justice, for which Mr. Rowington was taking a stand. But because government didn't, when government returned the list, usme do naam kam the, and those two guys were recommended by Mr. Nariman. So Justice Nariman took a stand. He said that now I will not let anybody's name get recommended before these two people are added to the list. So Justice Nariman, who was a very well-known senior advocate, he had a flourishing practice in Supreme Court. He was elevated from the bar and he always stood for meritocracy. So because of this, you know, jab tak Justice Nariman court mein the, tab tak koi bhi dusra naam recommend nahi ho sakta tha. And now because Justice Nariman retires, Justice Nariman occurs mein retire ho chuka, and because he retired, and now everybody in the Supreme Court started speaking up. So as the meme rightly says, pehle nahi bol sakti thi, who? The collegium. But ab bol sakti thi.
Nahi bol sakti thi.
Hallelujah!
Mera Yesu,
So collegium system has its own flaws and advantages. Achal, what are the negative sides? Just think about it. One judge, one of the senior five judges, one judge, if he decides, he can stall the process for almost 2 years. So if ek judge mana kar de, to 2 saal tak koi bhi Supreme Court mein naya judge nahin ban payega. Isn't it something very, something which can create difficulty for our judiciary to function properly? So what if Justice Nariman says ki mera recommendation nahin manoge, koi aur nahin jayega? Similarly, some other judge can also come up with such ego. Right? And what is the bright side of it? Bright side of it says that Indian judiciary still produces people who will not compromise on righteousness. So that is something to appreciate. Okay. Well, these are the 9 judges who are getting a seat in the prestigious Supreme Court of India. We have Justice A.S. Oka. He is currently Chief Justice of Karnataka High Court. Justice C.T. Ravi Kumar, he's a judge from Kerala High Court. We have Justice J.K. Maheshwari, Chief Justice of Sikkim High Court. Justice M.M. Sundaresh, a judge from Madras High Court. Justice Vikram Nath, Chief Justice of Gujarat High Court. P.S. Narasimha, the only lawyer in the list. He's a senior advocate. Justice B.V. Nagaratna. Guys, highlight this name. This name will become very important in the coming few years. So Justice B.V. Nagaratna, a judge from Karnataka High Court. Then we have Justice Bela M. Trivedi from Gujarat High Court, and Justice Hima Kohli, Chief Justice of Telangana High Court. So just 9 names, and you will start seeing these names in upcoming law scoop sessions as and when they deliver good judgments. So some key pointers: this is for the first time in Indian history that
थ्री वुमेन आर गेटिंग रिकमेंडेड एट दिस वेरी सेम टाइम, राइट? तो आपको लगता है इससे जुडिशरी का बहुत अच्छा होने वाला इन टर्म्स ऑफ जेंडर जस्टिस, इजंट इट? वेल, बिकॉज जितने वुमेन जस्टिस अभी हैं सुप्रीम कोर्ट में वो सब रिटायर हो जाएंगे. द लास्ट वन विल रिटायर इन सेप्टेम्बर, मिड सेप्टेम्बर. सो जो रेशियो है वो बढ़ नहीं रहा है. इट इज स्टिल 3-4 जजेस, उससे ज्यादा सुप्रीम कोर्ट में वुमेन को एंट्री अभी तक नहीं मिला है. सो इफ यू आर लुकिंग एट इट फ्रॉम जेंडर पैरिटी एंगल, देयर इज अ लॉट व्हिच नीड्स टू बी डन, राइट? बट अनदर ग्लास सीलिंग ब्रोकन, वी हैव अपॉइंटेड 3 जजेस टू द सुप्रीम कोर्ट टुगेदर. ओके, एंड द इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट इज जस्टिस बीवी नगरत्ना कुड एंड अप बिकमिंग द फर्स्ट वुमेन चीफ जस्टिस ऑफ इंडिया इफ एवरीथिंग गोज एज पर प्लान, right? If everything goes as per plan, she will become India's first Chief Justice, first women Chief Justice in 2027. Well, B.V. Nagaratna ke baare mein bhi hum baat karenge thoda zyada because she is important. Collegium system ka ek aur kharabi hai. There's one more negative side of it. Collegium system promotes nepotism. This is the biggest criticism that people come up with. Why does collegium system promote nepotism? Is because judges get to decide. The senior judges get to decide who will become judge after them, right? So that way, if you look at her history, B.V. Nagaratna's father was also India's Chief Justice at some point of time. In the year 1989, Nagaratna ke father, E.S. Venkatramaiya, bhi India ke Chief Justice reh chuke hain. So, do you see something fishy here? Justice Rowington Narriman ke father bhi legal field mein bahut bada naam the, right? You can go on and on. इनमें से ज्यादा लोगों के relatives आपको same field से मिल जाएंगे. Okay. So B.V. Nagaratna, presently a judge at Karnataka High Court. She started as a lawyer in Bengaluru. She was born in 1962. Nagaratna was appointed as additional judge in 2008 and later on elevated to the position of a permanent judge in couple of years. Another important name is P.S. Narasimha. So senior advocate Padmini Gantam Shri Narasimha is the only lawyer who is getting elevated this time. So he will become the 9th Supreme Court judge who got directly elevated from the bar. And another important thing, he might also end up becoming Chief Justice, though for a very brief period in 2028. Article 124 of the Constitution, you can read it verbatim, provides that there are 3 categories of people who can join Supreme Court as a judge, who can be elevated to the Supreme Court. If you read Article 124, it says, a person is eligible to be appointed as a judge of the Supreme Court if he or she has been a judge of a high court for how many years? At least 5 years. So if you have been a judge for at least 5 years, or you have been practicing law for at least 10 years at some high court. So someone who has been a judge at a high court for 5 years or more, someone who has been practicing litigation in the high court for 10 years, or any person who is a distinguished jurist. So these are the 3 categories of people who can be elevated to the Supreme Court. But category A, that means people from judiciary dominated. So hardly anyone from the other two will ever get a chance to get into the Supreme Court. Okay, there are many comments pouring in. I will just go through it quickly. Okay, Sashank says there are so many cases pending and it takes a lot of time to settle cases. That's true. And that is the reason, ek insan ka ego, agar hamari Supreme Court ko bina 10 judges ke chalne ke liye majboor kar sakta hai, to kitna galat hai. 34 ka capacity hai, 24 pe aap kaam chala rahe. Okay. Modi ji has to say something. Wait a second. Justice Akhil said something against Amit Shah, and in turn Amit Shah was sent to police custody and thus lost the chance to get into the new justice system. Okay. Chora says, yes, baby, I hope so. But sir, CGI, being a woman, a lot can change. Time ke saath, sab cheeze hone wali hain. Okay, chali, let's move on. Justice Sarvamitra Sikri is an important name, though not from that list of 9 judges, but he was the first lawyer to be elevated to the Supreme Court as a judge. So he was the first one. Justice Sikri was the first Supreme Court judge who was appointed directly from the bar. And Justice Sikri, India ke Chief Justice bhi reh chuke hain in 1971, turbulent times mein. Justice Sikri ka contribution aap dekh sakte hain that he was part of Keshwanand Bharti judgment. So Keshwanand Bharti is known for a very popular doctrine. Can someone name the doctrine in the comment section? Which doctrine was propounded by the Keshavananda Bharati judgment? Justice Sikri retired just a day after delivering Keshavananda Bharati verdict. So, Keshavananda Bharati judgment dene ke ek din baad Justice Sikri retire ho gaye. अच्छा, इससे पहले गोलकनाथ केस में भी ये हिस्सा थे. जस्टिस सीकरी के बारे में इतनी चीजें काफी हैं. He became Chief Justice in 71. He was part of Keshavananda Bharati in Golaknath. And he was the first lawyer to be elevated to the Supreme Court directly. Okay. By the way, Rohinton Dariman भी बार से ही elevate होके गए हैं. और सीकरी was the first one. So how does this all function? So Supreme Court में judges कैसे जाते हैं? Collegium system. अगर आप लोग बहुत पहले से देख रहे हैं episodes, तो हम लोग weekly law scope episode 6 में ये part cover कर चुके हैं. How the collegium system functions. But I will still try to give you a recap because many people join every week, so new people could be here. So collegium system basically means that the Chief Justice of India along with four other presiding judges, the next senior most judges, they sit together, that they form a core secret group, and they will consider names of worthy candidates. So people from lower judiciary, from high courts, people who are practicing at various benches and various high courts, they consider many things. For example, your integrity, your record, your contribution in lawmaking. Okay, we can understand about judges that judges, while delivering a verdict, they give new interpretation to any proposition of law, right? And thereby they are contributing in lawmaking, isn't it? So if a judge while reads in Article 21, that is right to life and liberty, and says that right to privacy is also part of right to life, right? So he expanded the scope of Article 21 and thereby, Puthuswamy judgment I'm referring here, thereby he contributed in lawmaking. But what about lawyers? How do they contribute in lawmaking? Basic structure doctrine is the correct answer, Sachitan, of the previous question. Yes, Keshavananda Bharati se basic structure doctrine aaya tha. Okay, another MCQ which generally people ask about Keshavananda Bharati is how many judges were part of the Keshavananda Bharati judgment? That was India's largest bench. So how many judges were there in the Keshavananda Bharati case? Okay, welcome Apurva, welcome Aditya. Okay. 5, 7, 10, 11, 13. Let's see how many of you get it right. Satyaj is the first one to answer this one. 13 judges. Sachetan says 13 judges. Ninya says 13. Arnik says 9. Well, correct answer is, guys, 13 judges. There were 13 judges in the Keshavananda Bharati case. And waha pe bhi unanimous opinion nahi tha. So 13 judges, 7:6 ratio. Agar ek aur judge dusri taraf chala jata to ye doctrine nahi aati. So 7:6 ke ratio mein verdict was delivered. So collegial system is an age old system which we have been following. Article 124 yahan pe bahut relevant ho jata hai. Chief Justice of India along with other four senior most judges of the Supreme Court, they decide upon the names of all these people. So I had asked one more question. How do lawyers contribute in lawmaking? Well, guys, obviously they do. Judges don't write judgments based on their whims and fancies. All the judgments are based on the argument put forth by the advocates. So whatever interpretation judges come up with, it is generally taken from the argument of one of the contesting lawyers. So somebody said something which made sense to the judge and that was included in the judgment. So yes, lawyers do contribute in lawmaking. Okay, couple of important articles here. Article 124 clause 2 talks about appointment of judges. Article 124 pe humne padha ki kis kis ko banaya ja sakta hai. Any judge who has practiced in who was a judge in high court for at least 5 years, any lawyer who has practiced in any high court for at least 10 years, or any person whom the president thinks that this guy is an eminent jurist. Okay, Article 124 clause 2 says that it talks about the process. Judges of the Supreme Court are appointed by the president. So rule says that they are appointed by the president after consultation with such a number of judges of the Supreme Court and the High Court in the states as the president may deem necessary for the purpose. Right? So ओरिजिनली दिस वॉज दी टेक्स्ट वर्बेटम, बट इंटरप्रिटेशन अभी चेंज हो चुका है. सो यहाँ पे जहां लिखा है एज मेनी एज द प्रेसिडेंट मे डीम नेसेसरी, नाउ वी हैव दैट नंबर 4. सो अदर जजेस कितने? 4. सो टोटल नंबर 5. ओके, वेर इट सेज प्रेसिडेंट आफ्टर कंसल्टेशन विद द चीफ जस्टिस. वेल, यहाँ पे कंसल्टेशन इज नॉट जस्ट एन एडवाइस, इट इज मोर ऑफ अ बाइंडिंग कंसल्टेशन. आर्टिकल 217 सेज दैट judges of high court shall be appointed by the president in consultation with the chief justice of India, governor of the state, and if you are appointing someone other than the chief justice of high court, then also with the chief justice of high court. So chief justice of that high court shall also be consulted. So process goes on like this. First of all, the collegium will consider all the names and then they will prepare a list. That list is then sent to the central government. So central government will go through the list. If they want to add any name to the list, they will also create their own list and central government will send that list to the collegium. So collegium apna list government ko deta hai. Government agar addition karwana chahti hai, to ek aur list collegium ko deti hai. If the collegium wants to consider those names which were added by the central government, it may. So it is their discretion if they want to consider those new names or not. But this is a step involved. So ye hoga. गवर्नमेंट के पास लिस्ट जाएगा, गवर्नमेंट भी अपना लिस्ट भेजेगा. मेनी टाइम दैट लिस्ट इज व्हाट दे रिसीव्ड एज इट इज, कुछ भी चेंजेस नहीं होते. बट इफ दे मेक अ फ्यू चेंजेस देन कॉलेजियम विल रीकंसीडर. इफ दे वांट टू रीकंसीडर दैट्स अप टू देम. देन दे विल रीसेंड द फाइनल लिस्ट टू द गवर्नमेंट फॉर गवर्नमेंट्स फाइनल अप्रूवल. गवर्नमेंट क्या करती है, गवर्नमेंट विल डू देयर बैकअप, गवर्नमेंट विल डू देयर बैकग्राउंड चेक. दे विल चेक वेदर दीज पीपल हैव बीन doing their duties properly, are there some objections by, let's say, IB or some other department of the government. They will find out. If there is no such thing, then government will provide its approval for these names. So government jo ab rectified list bhejta hai, wo wapas collegium ke paas jaati hai. Ab uske baad government ko use assent dena padta hai. But there's one big loophole, I have highlighted that. There is no time limit for the government to reply, right? So government can take how many, you know, whatever time they require, days, months, years altogether. But as far as appointment of Chief Justice is concerned, more or less it is sorted now. कि हमको नाम consider करने की ज़रूरत नहीं. क्यों नहीं है? Now the retiring Chief Justice of India, as a matter of custom, will recommend the name of the next senior most judge. Earlier this wasn't a rule; it was more of a practice. Now it is as good as a rule. It is as if this is the law. So the retiring Chief Justice recommends the name of the next senior most judge and president will have to accept that name, and therefore now we can predict that who is going to be the next Chief Justice of India, who will become Chief Justice after that, right? And that is how we know ki 2027 mein kaun Chief Justice banega, year 2028 mein kaun Chief Justice banega. Okay. So, this change was brought in after 1970. 1970 was a big controversial year in Indian judicial history. What happened in 1970 was that after the controversial judgment of Keshavananda Bharati, many people were punished for the side that they have taken. Government judges banane mein kahin na kahin role play karti hai directly and indirectly, but once somebody is appointed to the Supreme Court, elevated to the Supreme Court, there's little to nothing that government can do in order to stop that person from delivering judgment based on his or her own wisdom. So whatever the judge deems fit, they will decide. Judiciary ke rokne ke liye hamare paas option nahi hai government ke paas. Impeachment, we all know impeachment is an option, but impeachment is almost impossible in a country like India. Why? In order to impeach a high court or supreme court judge, there are only two valid grounds. Impeachment requires, first of all, 2/3 majority in the house. So parliament mein aapko 2/3 majority se impeachment motion pass karna padta hai. Plus there are only two grounds jis pe impeachment allowed hai. What are those two grounds? Proven misconduct and incapacity. Incapacity needs to be physical or mental. Judge pagal ho gaye, kuch kar nahi sakte. Incapacity is not about incompetency. So proven misconduct and proven misconduct and incapacity ki jo hum baat karte hain. Chaliye, let's move on. So Justice A. N. Ray was the fourth senior most judge in the Supreme Court back then, And once the Keshavanand Bharti case was decided, he was part of the minority opinion. That means he was favoring the government's stand. So later on, he was rewarded. Three other senior judges were superseded. Or teen logo ko jump karke, Justice A.N. Ray became the Chief Justice of India. So that is how government used to arm twist judges. Ki aapka seniority khatre mein, might be hum aapke jage kisi aur ka naam recommend kar denge. Right? After the A.N. Ray controversy, now it is more of a settled principle, settled rule, that the next senior most judge of the Supreme Court will become Chief Justice of India. Okay. Chale, so that day was referred to as the blackest day in Indian democracy in the judicial circuit. Well, guys, so it was a short session. We were just talking about judiciary appointments and various judges. If you want me to go in depth, if you want me to discuss any particular judge, you can mention that once this live stream ends in the comment section. So we'll go through the comment section and accordingly we'll cover areas in the next topic. Now I request all of you to quickly go to menti.com and enter code 1447-8520. 1447-8520. 1447-8520. I'm also entering the code in the chat box. You can check it there. So go to menti.com and use the code 1447-8520. Okay, Modi ji says ki thoda thoda dimag se upar se chala gaya. Don't worry. You don't have to appear in subjective test. So you will not have to explain the collegium system, but I will try to restate it once again for your understanding. So Article 124 of the Constitution says that judges of the Supreme Court can be selected from three different categories. Either we can elevate High Court judges to the Supreme Court. For that, that judge should be having experience of at least 5 years at a particular High Court, or let's say multiple High Courts. So minimum 5 years of judgeship at High Court is required in order to be elevated to the Supreme Court. Okay, but there are many judges who have completed 5 years at High Courts. Not all of them will get elevated to the Supreme Court. So this is for the collegium to decide. Then they can also pick lawyers, practicing advocates with minimum experience of 10 years, minimum standing of 10 years at a particular High Court. So, अगर कोई 10 साल से ज्यादा प्रैक्टिस कर रहा है उसे पिक कर सकते हैं, 5 साल से ज्यादा हाई कोर्ट में जज है उसे पिक कर सकते हैं, और समवन हु इज एन एमिनेंट ज्यूरिस्ट, बहुत बड़ा विद्वान, राइट? अच्छा, ये तो बेसिक एलिजिबिलिटी क्राइटेरिया है, बट कॉलेजियम विल डिसाइड अपॉन योर कैंडिडेचर बेस्ड ऑन योर बैकग्राउंड, दैट मीन्स योर इंटीग्रिटी, इज देयर एनी कंप्लेंट अगेंस्ट यू, करप्शन चार्जेस तो नहीं है, ब्रदर जजेस, फेलो जजेस क्या सोचते हैं आपके बारे में, हाउ मच हैव यू कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटेड इन द लॉ मेकिंग, इंटरप्रिटेशन ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल प्रोविजंस एंड थिंग्स लाइक दैट. एंड वंस द कॉलेजियम डिसाइड्स ऑन नेम्स, दे सेंड दैट लिस्ट टू द गवर्नमेंट, सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट. सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट ऑल्सो क्रिएट्स इट्स ओन लिस्ट एंड सेंड्स इट टू द कॉलेजियम, सो ग्रुप ऑफ सुप्रीम कोर्ट जजेस. सो नाउ दिस ग्रुप विल गेट टू डिसाइड वो नाम हमें रखने की नहीं. इफ दे वॉन्ट टू add names recommended by the government, those names will be added. If they don't want to, that's up to them. And once the final list is sent to the central government will do a background check on those guys, and later on central government has no option but to accept it. But how much time will the central government take in order to do all the background check and revert to the collegium? There is no specific time limit. So government indirectly can interfere in appointment of judges in the Supreme Court. How do they do that? By unnecessarily delaying their task. वो अपना काम करके नहीं देते. Okay. चलिए. Well, so this is for appointing judges or elevating judges to the Supreme Court. अच्छा, what about the Chief Justice of India? If we follow the same process of consultation, government approval, then government can misuse it. I gave you example of Justice A.N. Ray controversy. So Justice A.N. Ray was made Chief Justice of India and he superseded three of his senior most judges. You know, those judges resigned from Supreme Court because of this insult. Unse junior ko unke upar Supreme Court mein Chief Justice banaya gaya, so judges resigned from their post. The guy who was next in hierarchy, he resigned the very next day, right? So, isliye, now it is more of a rule that whenever Chief Justice of India retires, the next senior most judge will become the next Chief Justice. So, my question to you people, bonus question is, before this quiz starts, who is going to be the next Chief Justice of India? Find out. And we'll start the quiz. I see still some of you are not on Menti, guys. Menti.com. Go to Menti.com, M-E-N-T-I.com, and type the code 1447-8520. It won't take much time. Chali, let's. Move on. First question on your screen. You will get roughly 15 to 20 seconds to answer each question. Answer fast to get more points. Most of the questions relate to judiciary. Satesh came up with the answer. Vanshika says, Justice Oka, incorrect. Justice U.U. Lalit. Justice U.U. Lalit. Acha, kaise find out karenge? Go to Supreme Court's website. You will find the date of their appointment and as well as date of their retirement. Ab Supreme Court mein seniority kaise count hota hai? Number of days you have spent there. Not just based on your age. Aisa nahi ki jo sabse buddha hai, 65 ke paas hai, usi ko banayenge. Nahin. Based on your seniority as a Supreme Court judge. Who was the first judge of the Supreme Court of India elevated from the bar? Majority gave the correct answer. Sarvamitra Sikri. Justice Sikri is the correct answer. So Justice Narasimha, Justice Sikri, Justice Ray, Justice Nariman. Correct answer is Sikri. Let's move on to next question. Answer fast to get more points. Who has been appointed as Supreme Court judge by the President recently? Isme se kise Supreme Court ka judge recently banaya gaya hai? Justice P.S. Narasimha, Justice Mitra Sikri, Justice A.N. Ray, Justice Rowington Nariman. 5 seconds to go. Who has been appointed as the Supreme Court judge by the President of India recently? Justice Narasimha, Justice Sikri, Justice Ray, Justice Nariman. I hope all of you gave the answer. Correct answer is option A, Justice Narasimha. Well, Justice Nariman was also appointed from the bar, but he retired last week. So, Justice Nariman has retired. So, now, correct answer is Justice Narasimha. Next question on your screen. Quickly try to answer this one. Answer fast to get more points. Who will become the first women CJI? Who will become the first women Chief Justice of India? Well, nobody knows the future. Anything can go wrong. But as of now, if you look at the seniority list, we know that one of them will become CJI. Bela Trivedi, Indu Malhotra, B.V. Nagaratna, Fatima B.V. Bela Trivedi, Indu Malhotra, B.V. Nagaratna, Fatima B.V. Inme se kaun India ki pehli Chief Justice of India banne wali hai? Correct answer is B.V. Nagaratna. If everything goes, you know, as expected. Nobody dies, nobody is, you know, elevated. Chek hai, chaliye. God give her good health. That is what we wish for. Next question. Who was the first women judge of the Supreme Court? Who was the first women judge of the Supreme Court? Options are still same. Justice Bela Trivedi, Justice Malhotra, Justice Nagaratna, Justice Fatima Bibi. 33% chance hai correct answer dene ka, even if you don't know the answer. Who was the first women to become judge of Supreme Court of India? Justice Trivedi, Malhotra, Nagaratna or Fatima Bibi? Correct answer is Justice Fatima Bibi. Justice Fatima Bibi was the first women judge of our apex court. Chaliye. So first kaun tha? Ye sawal kai baar aata hai law entrance exam mein if you are appearing in multiple exams. Okay, correct answer is Justice Fatima Bibi. Let me give you some more connected questions. Let's see. Many people get confused because of these questions which you will see now. Next question on your screen. So, first women judge of Supreme Court, you know. Who was the first women judge of the Supreme Court? Oops. Yeah, I think galat maine mark kar diya. Question, this one shall not be counted. Answer was not. Okay. Leela said, what is the correct question here? Question is, who was the first women to become Chief Justice? So, Justice Leela Seth was the first lady who became Chief Justice of any High Court. Do you know which High Court was she heading? She became the first lady chief justice of a high court. Which high court was Justice Leela Seth chairing? Answer in the chat box. We'll move on to the next question. Next question also related or somehow connected on your screen. Answer fast to get more points. So Fatima Bibi, who was the first woman judge of the Supreme Court? Oops, I think questions mein kuch garbar hai. Anyways, I will leave, I will change it for you. Who was the first judge? Who was the first woman to become judge? That is the question. First woman to become judge, not of a Supreme Court, any court. First woman to become judge. First woman to become judge. Correct answer for that one is... Oops. Chaliye. Thoda sa isme garbad tha, so I will correct your answers here. Don't take it as the correct answer. Era Chandy was the first lady to become judge. First lady to become a judge in India was Era Chandy. Cornelia Sorabji was the first lady to practice. First woman to practice at bar was Cornelia Sorabji. Cornelia Sorabji sabse pehli mahila hai jinhone practice karna shuru kiya. At that time, legal field was not considered good for women and therefore hardly a few used to join bar. So Cornelia Sorabji was
the first one to do that. Era Chandy was the first woman to become a judge. Era Chandy became the first woman judge. And entire Commonwealth, she was the second woman judge. Commonwealth means all British, the entire British Empire. Leela Seth became the first Chief Justice of a High Court. Leela Seth became the first Chief Justice of a High Court. And Fatima Bibi was the first lady to join the Supreme Court as a judge. These are the four names which you should note down somewhere with their achievements. These questions have been asked multiple times in past year papers. Okay, question number 7. Let's see, second last question. Who was the first woman judge in India? I already gave you the answer, so galat mat batayega, please. Okay, Modi has a question. Kya ye system seniority over merit ko prioritize nahi karta hai? Nahi karta hai. Why? Because in order to get elevated, your merit is considered as the top priority. So not everybody who has seniority becomes a judge. So when you get appointed as a judge in lower judiciary, you will serve there for decades. Till you reach the age of 60 years, you will keep on serving as a judge. And when we have to elevate somebody to the high court, we look at the senior most judges, the pool of senior most judges in the lower judiciary, and we pick the most talented one, the most meritorious one from the senior most judges. Not the senior most judge, but from the pool of senior most judges. Those people will start working at the high court level. They will retire at the age of 62. Now, when we have to pick judges for the Supreme Court, we will look at the pool of judges at the high court. Ab high court ke sirf senior most nahi, from among the senior most judges, the most talented of the lot will be elevated to the Supreme Court. So that is how it works. So we are not prioritizing seniority over merit. So it is not just the age. So article 124 bata rahe, kitne saal ki judgeship chahiye high court mein? 5 years. So someone who has served at least for 5 years. So let's say agar aap 60 touch hone wale the, retirement se ek mahina pehle aapko high court bhej diya jata hai. You are 59 years 11 months old and now you became a high court judge. So for how many years, months, days are you going to be a judge at the high court? Answer is only a month. And therefore, answer is you will get hardly 2 years. Jab aap 62 nahi ho jate. Isliye aapko senior most judge banne ka mauka to milega nahi. Aap 5 years cover nahi kar payenge. To aap nahi ban sakte. So, जो थोड़ी यंग एज पे हाई कोर्ट पहुंचते हैं उन्हीं को आगे 5 ईयर सर्व करने के बाद सुप्रीम कोर्ट जाने के चांसेस रहते हैं. सो इट इज नॉट जस्ट सीनियोरिटी. ओके, चलिए लेट्स मूव ऑन टू लास्ट क्वेश्चन फॉर द डे. अ वेरी सिंपल क्वेश्चन, एवरीबडी शुड आंसर इट करेक्टली. कोलेजियम फॉर अपॉइंटमेंट ऑफ सुप्रीम कोर्ट जजेस कंसिस्ट ऑफ CJI एंड डैश मोर जजेस. वॉट इज द करेक्ट आंसर? 33, 13, 5 और 4. Collegium requires how many judges? So it consists of CJI and dash. Let's see what people have to say. Correct answer is 4. Still many people got it wrong. CJI plus 33 is the total sanctioned strength of the Supreme Court. So collegium does not consist of all the judges of the Supreme Court, only the top five, the five senior most judges that are Supreme Court, which will obviously include Chief Justice of India because he is generally the senior most person, and four other people, right? Okay, Government of India tried to change this collegium system. They also came up with a new law which was called NJAG, National Judicial Appointment Commission, which Amendment Act was brought in to change the collegium system. Can someone answer this one? Which Amendment Act was brought in to change the collegium system? Your options are 99th, 100th, 101st, 102nd. 99th, 100th, 101st, 102nd. Manjusha is the first one to answer. Manjusha says 99th, Ira says 99th, Harshada says 99th. Guys, 99th Constitutional Amendment Act is the correct answer. But the moment government brought it in, the moment it was passed, the very next event was Supreme Court declaring 99th Amendment Act ultra vires to the Constitution. So, government koshish kar chuki hai is system ko change karne ka, but judiciary was adamant. Judiciary ne us amendment act ko hi ultra vires declare kar diya. So, we are still stuck with collegium system. Chaliye, let's see who is the winner today. So, leaders board mein, if we see a new name, we would be happy to know. Rebit, Apurva, Sanjana, A, Satej, Malvika. Who is the fastest one? Correct answer is Ribbit. Ribbit, congratulations, buddy. So I'm happy to see a new name today. That means CLAT 22 and 23 students are catching up. Chaliye. Thank you so much for attending to this session. I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope you guys got to learn something new. If you want me to cover any particular thing in next episode, please let me know. I would be more than happy to do that. I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope you guys like this session. अगर आपको पसंद आया तो अपना feedback chat box में छोड़ जाइए या फिर stream खत्म होने के बाद comments section में आप लिख सकते हैं. Feel free to like, share and subscribe. If you subscribe and ring the bell icon, you will be notified as and when we conduct these sessions. And don't forget to share it. याद रखिए, बांटने से ज्ञान बढ़ता है और साथ में subscribers भी. चलिए. Bye guys. We'll meet again.